Hi everyone, this is Lada from astrolada.com and I'm here with Nikola Stojanovic, your favorite astrologer. Hi Nikola.
Hi, hello there, hello there. Hello to everybody.
And thank you for being here, and this is such a fantastic topic, how to recognize and find the best position in your horoscope, whether it's planet or aspect, or configuration, and how to use it to attract the easiest success and the most success in your life.
Yes, so the topic of this webinar is how to find what is the best is in somebody's chart, you know. It can be one aspect, it can be only one planet in a good house, in a good sign, you know. But people often make mistake, you know, subconsciously. They most of them do it subconsciously. Our first choice, subconsciously, is our first house and planets in the first house, and also the ruler of the first house.
Mm-hmm. So they might think this is what they want.
Yes, yes. But what is the problem there? If the ruler of the first house is in good aspects, that is the good choice, that is the best choice. Yeah. And people should hold on it, you know, because their life will be nice, good planets, good aspects, you know, no problem. You know. But many people don't have the ruler of the first house in good aspects. And also the ruler of the first house might be in some bad house, you know, so in bad aspects. So many years of their life, they hold on it and they spent doing, you know, lots of things, but the result is null, you know. They
yeah,
do
like
nothing.
They want to be
work,
a,
you know, work all day long, but, you know, no money, no success. Nobody recognizes it as success. And many years pass, you know. So so many people are misguided with that. So what is the point of astrology? The point of astrology is to find what is the best in our chart and to input, you know, all efforts in that direction. And then our life will be much better. We will be more happier, you know, we'll make money, and when you have money, you have opportunities. And that is the point of our new webinar, how to recognize it, what is the best in our chart.
By the way, I want to say that it's going to be on the 26th of November, Sunday. It's a month from now, basically, from 12 o'clock Pacific time. If you can be present, of course, you can watch it after that, the recording. So yeah, guys, get your seat in advance. We have a month before the webinar. But what if a person has no good thing in their horoscope? Have you seen such a thing?
There must be something. I have prepared one fantastic, several fantastic examples, you know. Extremely bad charts, you know. But there must be something in the chart that is good or might be good. I will show it on webinar. And here I have one example. First, I will tell you the story. You know, my client, she was my client maybe 3-4 months ago. And the last 17 years, she was a lawyer, very good one. And one day she decided to quit that job. She was very good in that, making lots of money, also a lawyer, you know. And she decided to do what she wanted to do when she was young, you know. She wanted to be a doctor, but she couldn't go to university to study it, so she decided to learn it, you know, on many seminars. And she opened alternative medicine center. And now we'll see her chart. Okay, can you see the chart?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So her ascendant is in the sign of Cancer, and the cusp of her ascendant is at 19 degree. That is the degree of Libra, yes? And her first choice was to be a lawyer. Libra rules with everything with law. Okay, so the cusp of her first house at 19 degree, the degree of Libra, put her into that job, you know, to be a lawyer. And look this, in her sixth house, the house of work, it begins in the sign of Sagittarius, and the ruler Jupiter is in the sign of Libra. Fantastic. It's very good for lawyer. Libra rules with law, Jupiter rules with lawyers. Her Jupiter has sextile to Uranus, sextile to Saturn, good aspects. And she was very good lawyer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me? Okay.
Yeah.
So, but, you know, what happened, you know, Uranus, she has Uranus in the first house. Uranus is near the cusp of her second house, but it is still in the first house. So Uranus represents changes, you know. When people have Uranus in the first house, there comes the moment that they want to change their life completely. Uranus represents completely change. So when Uranus was in the sign of, it was the year 2000, you know, when Uranus was in the sign of Aquarius, making exact opposition to her son, you know. So she suddenly decided to stop being a lawyer, and she decided to fulfill her dream to open an alternative medicine center. Why? Because the ruler of her ascendant, the moon, is in the sign of Pisces. Pisces rules with medicine, you know. So mm-hmm. all her life she wanted to be a doctor or something like that, to help people, to heal people, you know. But it was very bad choice. Why? Because moon doesn't have good aspects. Moon has the square to Saturn. Moon has opposition to Mercury and Venus. Moon can in conjunction with, with Uranus and the Sun, you know. Not good aspects.
Yeah.
So for the next 17 years, she has been practicing medicine, you know, but with no results, you know. She couldn't make money. And money was very important. Money is important for everybody, but especially for her. Why? Because she has three planets in the second house, the house of money. And there is also the ruler of the second house, money, is in the second house, the Sun is. Yes. Mm-hmm. So when you work something and you have this in your chart, especially the ruler of the second house in the second house, you can't be happy if you don't make money. So she had lots of problems. She also lost her house, you know. Why lost her house? Because moon also represents house in the sign of Pisces, to lose. The ruler of the moon is Neptune in the fourth house, her home, you know. So she lost, you know, her home also. And she didn't have money for living, you know. You have bills to pay, you have children, and, you know. So, and I also told her, you should stop this work. Why? Because she has the moon, ruler of her ascendant, her physical body, square to Saturn, you know. Saturn have problems. And moon square to Saturn represent very sick people, you know. And moon represents her physical body. What does it mean? It means that in time she will start being very sick, you know. Because when you deal with sick people, they will come with their bad energies. So you must have very strong chart. You must clean yourself from that energy if you want to stay healthy, you know. But she told me, you know, she was starting to be sick, you know. So I stopped her. I told her to stop with that job. And she asked, and yes, she also told me that she wants to go to some little place to live where nature is nice, and that she wants to produce healthy food, you know, organic food,
yeah.
But she doesn't have money for that, you know. So she was in great troubles, and she asked me what to do, you know. So I explained her. I told her, go back being a lawyer. You can go back, and you can start your job, your real job, the good job again, you know. Why? Because the ruler of sixth house, Jupiter, is in the sign of Libra, to be a lawyer, is in sextile, good aspect, to Saturn. Saturn is coming back. Saturn represents the situation in life when we want to go to do something again, you know.
Saturn. Repeat.
Yes, to repeat. Yes, yes. And Jupiter is in sextile to Saturn, so she can make comeback, you know. And Jupiter and Uranus, astrologer, told her sextile to Jupiter, trying to Saturn, you know, go back Saturn to your job, Jupiter in the sign of Libra, make money. And when you make money, you know, she's a lawyer, she's a very good lawyer also. Then you can invest your money in what you want to do, you know, to go to live somewhere in the nature, you know, to produce healthy food, organic food, you know, and to have a peaceful life. Why she wants to go out of, she was living in LA, I think, yes. Because she has the moon, in moon is also home, moon is representing her, and in the sign of Pisces, it means to run away from everything, you know. So when people want to run away, like her, they will go to some village or little place, you know, in some nature, something like that. So she can, what is the best in her chart? Jupiter in sector to Uranus, sector to Saturn. So to be again Saturn, a lawyer, Jupiter, to make money and to invest money in her new home, you know, in some nature, some countryside. So this is the best in her chart. You know, I was thinking when I saw her chart and read her life story, I was thinking almost one all day, you know, because she has lots of bad aspects of the moon, you know. Mm-hmm. So I realized that I have to tell her to quit it, you know, because one day she will be very sick working that job. And also she doesn't have money. You know, when you're sick, you must have money, you know, to give it to doctors and for healing. So, and then I saw, you know, Jupiter, and I asked her, why don't you go back and be a lawyer? And look what she told me, you know. The destiny sent you some sign, you know. When she heard my story, she told me that several days before our conversation, she had a client, you know, a very successful lawyer, and she told her, why don't you go back to your job to be a lawyer? You can work with me, you know. He offered her a job. So you know, the sky tell her, you know, go back, do that, you know, because she was a very great lawyer, very good lawyer, you know. So this is Jupiter sextile to Saturn, sextile to Uranus. And she told me, yo, thank you very much. You know, I have been waiting for 7 years somebody to tell me to do that. Okay. So, can you see me now?
Yes, I see you. And do you look at dignity of planets? Because she had, for example, Sun in own sign and Mercury.
Yes, but listen, the Sun is at what degree? At the 19th degree. The ruler of the second house, the house of money, is in the sign of Leo, but what degree? 19th degree, the degree of Libra, again being a lawyer, you know, again the same. You know. So we have lots of information in different way when you watch the chart. You know, the same information can be found in several times. But the best aspect in her chart was that Jupiter, ruler of her sixth house job, in Libra, in good aspects, you know. So she decided, you know, she told me I should have met you 17 years ago. And listen, what is also the trap in mislead? The ruler of her ascendant is in the sign of Pisces. So she told me it was my dream, you know, to be a doctor. Dreams, you know, Pisces, Dr. Pisces, you know. But that moon has no good aspect, so it's not good for her, you know. She only lost her time, and in time she would be very sick, because what? You know, doctor touch people. When you touch somebody, doctor must touch patients, you know. So when you touch them, you take their bad energy, because they will come sick, you know. Right. They don't work with healthy people. So So when somebody is sick, it means their bad energies are in power, you know. And when doctor touch them, they take that energy. So doctor must know that. Most of them don't, you know. And I know, I have many friends doctors, you know. I'm telling them, you know, when you go home, they should take off all the clothes. And they must go to shower, you know, to clean their bad energies from them. You know? And what you wear in home or out to work, you must not wear where you work, you know, because your clothes will also take bad energy. You know? Mm-hmm. And many doctors die because they don't know that, and they don't know that they should clean themselves. Huh. It's normal. Lisa, when I start learning astrology, I decide my ascendant was in Virgo. Ascendant, first choice, you know. And Mercury, ruler of my ascendant, was in the sixth house, the house of healing. So I decided, I said to myself, I will be master in health astrology, medicine astrology. But very soon I realized why, because my ascendant is Virgo. Virgo is healing, you know, to be healthy. The ruler in the sixth house, also the house of, in a way, medicine and healing. So that was my first choice, you know, the ruler of ascendant. But very soon I said to myself, when I get to know astrology better, you know, I said, no, this is not good, you know. If I work on medical astrology, sick people will come, will be my clients. And I will do prognosis, you know, analyze their chart for health, and I will take bad energy from their chart. So one day I will be sick, you know. So I stopped doing that. And one my friend, very great astrologer, you know, especially she is a specialist for medicine astrology. I think she is the best in the world for that. She is from time to time she becomes very sick, you know. Wow. Every 3-4 months she goes to some doctors, you know. Why? Because she has lots of sick clients, you know. They want to see what's going on with their health and what's the problem, because they are not happy with doctors, you know. So, and every 3-4 months she goes to doctors. And I told her, stop doing that, you know. Because she is a good astrologer, she can do other things. But, you know, she likes it. You know, she has the sun in Pisces in the first house.
Yeah, it's a first choice.
To be, you know, a doctor, you know. But not so good chart, so that's why she's...
And can you do something, say, if your ascendant has only good aspects to the degree of the ascendant, but maybe not the ascendant ruler? Can you still do something that is according to the sign of the ascendant?
But, you know, planet is more important than ascendant, you know. Ascendant is, everything is important in our chart. But ascendant, you know, is important, but the ruler of the ascendant or the planets in the first house, they have more, they are more important. So. Mm-hmm. And I have to tell you, do you know that Catalonia has proclaimed their... they want to separate from Spain, yes. When did they do that? When the moon, people, was at the 0 degree of Aquarius, you know. 0 degree Aquarius, you know, to divorce, to split.
Yeah.
To be independent, you know.
Independence, so. Freedom.
Yes. Okay. I just wanted to tell you that it doesn't have anything with this we are talking. But it was interesting.
And apparently Spain is ruled by Sagittarius and Saturn is in Sagittarius now.
Yes. And also Spain is Taurus in their genetic chart, you know. And when Uranus enters the sign of Taurus, they must, you know, divorce.
Separate.
Yes. And all countries born, you know, in their genetic charts in the sign of Taurus, we'll have the same situation, you know. Turkey, they are something bad must happen there, you know. And also South Germany is Taurus too. And they, you know, in South Germany, the most richest men in Germany live in the South Germany, around Munich. So that area is also Taurus. Maybe they will want to separate from Germany, you know. We'll see.
Autonomous.
It will be very, And in Serbia, you know, part of Serbia called Vojvodina, south, North Serbia, he was born also in the sign, in their genetic chart, in the sign of Taurus. So we all know that here, they will try to separate from Serbia.
Again, come on.
But all of it is done by some very large and important country. We all know what country. Yeah. I told many yes. I told many months ago. I think that. What did I say? What did I want to say? I forgot.
I forgot.
I said something, but I can't remember what now. Oh, yes, I said that America is pushing Europe into the war with Russia, you know, and they also want Europe to be weak. They are just pretending that they are friends, but they are not. There are no friends in politics. And
no.
Only interest. Yes. Okay, good. So let's go back to this topic. So we'll talk what is the best in our chart, how to recognize it. And, you know, people will be happy when they realize what is the best in their chart and we can, you know, all our efforts can be pushed in that direction. Now life will be much, much better.
And the aspects are the most important thing to look at?
Yes. Aspects, everything is important. Aspects, you know, the house, the degree also, you know. Uh-huh. Look at this chart, you know, of this woman. She has the ruler of the second house in the second at the degree of Libra, 19, you know, so. Yep. So being a lawyer is really the best for her.
Yeah.
And you know, yeah, and it is her destiny to be a lawyer. No, not. But yeah, all of us have some traps in our chart, you know, something that will mislead us.
And are there also some, just like when you did the webinar on bad aspects and how to offset bad aspects, that was like, you can say, drinks with drinks if you have moon with Venus difficult aspect. But is there something else, like a talisman we can wear for the best aspect in our horoscope? Say, if you have Jupiter sextile Uranus, that you can carry something with you to enhance this energy, or?
Yes, there are remedies. We were talking about remedies. We can do another webinar about remedies, you know. And we should do webinar about who killed John Kennedy, Fitzgerald Kennedy. I have done my investigation many years ago. I will write a book.
The killer?
I have maybe about 60 or 70 charts of people involved, you know. It will be very, very interesting to hear. We can do it later, you know.
Maybe. Yes, next year.
It will be very, very interesting, you know. They are hiding something, obviously, and they must hide it because.
Yes, and actually, President Trump wanted to release those files, but now he said, "I'm not allowed to. They're not allowing me. It's dangerous to release."
Naturally. But why?
We'll find out.
Okay, we all know the truth, you know. You know, listen, I have to say that JFK, he has in the eighth house, the house of dying, I think he has five planets, five out of ten.
Wow.
I think five, maybe, I'm not sure, maybe four, but four or five, I can't remember now. So listen, one planet is one person.
Oh,
so it can't be only one killer, you know. It's impossible, you know.
Wow.
There is Mars, there is Jupiter, there is, I think, Venus. Not Venus. There is Mercury and something else, I think.
I think Mars.
So, you know, it can't be only one person. It's impossible. Because, you know, each planet represents one person or persons, you know. But he has four planets, four or five in the eighth house. So how come only Lee Harvey Oswald? Impossible. And also in the chart, it was easily seen where did the killing shoot came from. It's easy to see it. It's a joke. You know?
Yeah, and they said there were more than one.
And when you realize from where the shooting came from, you will see that there were several killers, not only one.
So it was all planned.
So when you have several killers, it must be assassination attempt. It must be, you know,
A coup.
A plot, yes, coup. Yes, it was coup.
So okay, if a planet is a person, someone with three planets in the seventh house might marry three times.
Yeah, yes, you might.
My best friend has four planets there, so she's on the third now.
That's life. No, that's life. He lives in the age of Aquarius, you know. Aquarius means divorce, many, we become like with one person, you know, 40, 50 years, like people before, you know, before it was the age of Pisces, you know, so they could in that time. And especially, you know, if they married in church, they couldn't divorce, you know, because it was the age of Pisces. Religion was very strong then. But now, Aquarius. Okay, good.
Well, thank
but
you.
But you're happy in your marriage. Listen, keep you know, be happy. You must be happy more, you know. Enjoy your marriage. Do you have any good news for us all?
Ah, yeah, everyone knows. Yeah, we're waiting for a second baby.
Yes. So it means you're happy in your marriage. Good, great, fantastic. You deserve it. You are a nice lady.
Thank you, Nicole.
Well, and you know, many people like you. You know, when I receive emails, they all, you know, say something nice about you. Many people like you. You should know that.
Oh, that's so nice. It's my Aquarius ascendant. Aquarius, it's likable.
Yes. Okay, good.
With only good aspects, you know. So I come across nice.
Lucky you. No, you have very nice personality. We are talking about you now. Do you know why? The moon is passing over your first house.
Exactly. So, yeah. I'm blushing now.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much. So I can't wait to learn how to find the best position in your horoscope.
Yes, I will hear very good examples, you know. Maybe 7, 8. I will see, you know.
Wonderful.
Very good.
That's the best way to learn through examples, basically.
Yes, the best
and
way.
And at the end, we'll have a Q&A so people can ask questions.
Yes, why not? No problem.
Well, 26th of November, guys, remember, come join. Yes. Nicola Stojanovic. I'll put the link for the webinar. I can't wait for that webinar. Another
exciting. Okay, don't forget to join us. Don't forget.
Yes, thank you so much. Have a great day.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.